Newman here is a Group Chief Executive Officer at Treasury Consulting and also a venture capitalist. Standing today on 16th August 2019, we are going to be shooting a very important video wherein I would like to let you know something very important which is happening at Treasury Consulting. So, as you understand that, Treasury Consulting is a consultancy company which we are based out at Hong Kong, Singapore and India. Nowadays, I'm spending my time in India as a project Julia is going on, followed by the project Smith will go on, which would be approximately 1000 FX combinations that come in the public domain and which would be much bigger than you have on the Bloomberg and the Reuters. Reuters is having almost 10-20 and Bloomberg is having 20. Treasury Consulting is extremely is dedicated to make Julia the world's largest, the world's first derivative board to the maximum extent. And today we have 16 asset classes and I would like to take this to 32. Our idea is very clear that before November 2019, when the Singapore FinTech Festival will start, you know, at Changi, basically at the Changi Exhibition Center, we go to be the first company in the globe wherein Julia would be offering almost everything in the derivative. And we are very clear that Julia's job is very clear. The job which has been assigned to Julia is to make sure that whatever is there at the front offices of the bank has to be available in the public domain, except pricing. Pricing is the consultancy part which will never come in the public domain. Now Treasury Consulting, as you know that when I started the company, it was in July 2016. It's a very modest start. Every startup starting with a modest and we are not a VC funded company. We ourselves is a self-reliant company and all operations of the company is from the own profitability. We are a very high profitable company because we offer a lot of different things and God willing, the quality of the services and at the same point of time, the ability to offer 10 different things of a simple problem is something which we have. Now we have decided to enter into the media domain. And in this media domain, we are going to be launching our own documentary. And that documentary we titled Documentary Ka Movie, actually. That documentary, I titled this as The Life in Treasury Market. As you know that when 2008 and 2010 financial, between 2008 and 2010, when the financial crisis happened, afterward Hollywood made few movies like the Shorts, you know, The Big Shorts, my favorite, The Margin Call. But in this movie, actually they have not, with due respect, they have not shown that who is who, basically who did that. Actually, so just like you must have watched various Bollywood and various multiple movies of the multiple countries of criminal movies wherein somebody came and killed somebody and then interrogation started, basically FBI, like basically Hollywood, the FBI came in and FBI or sometimes CIA also, they both came in and they investigate who killed that and finally you get to know, oh, I never thought he killed that. He used to be a very good friend of that person. So I am having with due respect feel that the Margin Call and the Big Shots and multiple movies, they have not shown what actually has to be shown to the public. And that is one of the reasons that even after 2008, the banking crisis never stopped. Now, yesterday we got a news that the Danish bank started with the negative interest rate loan. We're going to have a policy, we're going to have a video on that as well, not to worry about. Because I hope you appreciate that from the last several months, I'm raising my voice that NIRP, negative interest rate policy, is growing. And according to the figures which I got today in the media, that according to the Bloomberg, approximately $13 trillion worth of the total corpus, which is one third of 13 is 39, is invested under NIRP, which is negative interest rate policy. And today figures in the media is exactly opposite, which is 19 trillion. So if I go with the same 39 divided by 19, this proportion is more than 33%. So that I need to check and vet from our friends in banking. That is why we are not confirming whether this number right or wrong, but we're surely going to have a video about NIRP. Please be rest assured. So we are shooting our movie come documentary, which is Life in Treasury Market. This movie will have following features. Number one, this movie will talk about that how the life of a treasurer actually is. It's a very stressful life. It's roughly 5:30 in the morning and I'm working. And you would be surprised to know that tomorrow I'm having a guest lecture at a business school. And that guest lecture needs to be delivered at 10 a.m. So practically I have 5 a.m. In this 5 hours, I have to sleep. and I have to go back to that business school and deliver. And when I come back, I need to start working again. So we discuss about that, how stressful is the life of a treasurer. You know, people are always fascinated that you work in a, you work as a banker in Goldman Sachs, Standard Chartered, JP Morgan or multiple banks, earning $1 million bonus. Anyways, the $1 million bonus time has gone now. So nobody's earning $1 million bonus. In fact, CEOs are not getting the salary. We have just saw that HSBC CEO was all of a sudden asked to go, or he either he stepped down or he was asked to go, I don't know. But the basically the news is there that it's just like what you can make out that he was asked to go, but apparently speaking in writing he stepped down. But anyways, God knows what about that. We're going to discuss how difficult is the life of a corporate treasurer. Now the movie will talk about numbers, fact, figures from 2008 till 2019. A lot of research would happen, there is no doubt about that, and this research is subject to scrutiny as well. I know that after the movie will come, there would not, there some banks might disregard that movie. I'm open for that. Now, few facts about the movie which I'm going to be disclosing in the public domain. The reason is because today is 15. You know, 5-7 days from now, we are going to be starting the movie. We are starting the movie. Few facts about the movie would be, first of all, the movie will not be in the Hindi. So please don't expect that movie to be in the Hindi. Not a single line of the movie would be in the Hindi. This movie would completely be shooted in English, and that movie and this movie will basically divide into four parts. So it would be shooted in the four locations. So number one thing, that movie would 100% be English. It will not be shooted in Hindi. So if you're expecting that I'm going to be shooting a movie like Shah Rukh Khan and Salman Khan in Hindi, I'm sorry, it would completely be in English. If that disappoints you, my apologies, but no Hindi. Secondly, this movie would be shooted in four different locations. The first location would be in the four different locations in the four different phases. The first location, the first phase would be India, wherein we would be shooting the movie at our India office and also in one of the 7-star accommodations, JW Marriott and ITC Moria. I don't think that both require introduction. JW Marriott is an American brand, while ITC Moria is well known in India and outside India as well, where American presidency came and lived. In fact, the Saudi crown, Prince Mohammed bin Salim, and the Russian president Vladimir Putin, they were also being the respected guest of India at ITC Moria. So three different locations we are going to be shooting. One is the Indian office, one is the ITC Moria, and one is the JW Marriott. Total movie is 3 hours, wherein we have decided that the 25 to 30 minutes of the movie would be shooted in India, which is the first piece. This would be the introduction of the movie, wherein exactly, and in this we would be covering that how the life of the corporate treasurer would be, how difficult would be the life, what are the stress they are facing, and how the stress grew like this when the recessions has come, like we have today. Then the second piece of the movie would be shooted somewhere in October and November in Singapore. We based out at Singapore, and in Singapore, wherein the prime locations would be our Singapore office, which is at Marina One. We would be shooting few part at MBS Hotel, Marina Bay Sands Hotel. The third would be shooting outside MAS, Monetary Authority of Singapore, and outside the Parliament of the Singapore. Of course, the requisite approval has to be taken. We will take that, not to worry about. So second part we would be shooting in Singapore, and this part would be covering about all formalities, which are the number part of the movie. When we talked about effective 2008 till now, what are the total casualties that happened to the corporate treasurer, how many banks being busted, how many losses that happened to the equity markets, and everything, basically debt market, currency market, who do what and how. Please be rest assured that movie will share I would say not a Bible, but a kind of a small book. And that book is a small page, a 5-7 page book. That book would be covering the sources of that information. So whatever information we would be using in the movie, we're going to have that a book wherein you can see that we have taken this information from that book. So no information is from our side. Even if we have taken from Bloomberg, we give you the screenshot of the Bloomberg. So please be rest assured. Third part of the movie would be shooted in Hong Kong, which is somewhere in December. In this part, we would be talking about, we will cover the global financial centers, the role of a treasurer in a global financial center, just like Singapore, Hong Kong, London, and US, and how it is changing considering the trade wars, considering the basically the Brexit, which is probable in October, hope so, and considering the fallout of Hong Kong because of the protest, considering the Singapore is under the grip of recession, and so many things. Fourth part would be shooting in Dubai, a country who wanted to be on blockchain 1st January 2021. And according to the mandate by the government, the local government, Dubai government, that no office of the Dubai government, basically the government office in Dubai, will issue the paper. Everything would be online. So we would be using the shooting the fourth part in Dubai. That would be outside Burj Khalifa, and we have not yet decided which location, with what else location we are going to be using. So at four locations the movie is going to be shooting. I repeat, which is India, 30 minutes. Roughly 1 hour movie would be shooting in Singapore at multiple time. Then we club the, I would say, the videos. And then we would be shooting one in Hong Kong. And the fourth, the final piece would be shooting in Dubai. At the last, we are expecting to take, since the bandwidth of the company is very limited, you know that, and also we are into so many projects like Project Julia, Project Smith, and a lot of clients' projects are also going on. So it's immense blessing that company is very profitable and we are getting a lot of respect from client. So we are expecting that the movie to be completed by end of January, after all due diligence and cuts and all, whatever the movie basically the producers do. We are taking professional help of my very good friend who is also a director. If he is watching this video, he do have a smile on his face. And at the end of the January, the company would be shooting this, the company would be launching this movie on the platforms like Amazon, like Netflix, and multiple platforms. Like, there are a lot of media reports which does suggest that the Flipkart is also coming up with their own platform in the movie. God knows how this would work, but hopefully by that time the platform would come. Company idea is that the production house which the company is starting, this production house would be shooting short documentaries about various part of the financial markets at least twice in a year. So considering the bandwidth and the time availability, we are expecting that this time we would take 6 months to shoot the first movie, and hopefully if everything will go well and as per plan, where I am very hopeful, because whatever projects company has taken till now, company concluded that. So we are hopeful that company would basically would be starting second movie somewhere at the end August, which is 365 days from now. Generally we close our first movie in the August 20, we'll start another movie just before the launch of our petroleum business in Saudi Arabia. Before concluding this video, I would like to assure you a few things. Number one, I'm not paid and sold media. So do not expect that I will give a rosy picture of somebody and I will give you a bleak picture of somebody. I will tell you what is the reality. If Mr. X, who might be a billionaire, trillionaire, if he is not good, we will say he is not good. If Mr. Y, who is not a billionaire and a trillionaire, but if he is good, but he is good. The movie to be shooted in the particular location, and the movie would be covering holistic part of the treasury market, which covers Singapore, Hong Kong, Dubai, US, London, the marine business, Bahrain and all. As you know, that company is very serious setting up the Bahrain, the marine business. You can see that I am watching this, reading this magazine very often nowadays. Last but not the least, company will give you some company. This movie is all about that how you can secure your future in the treasury market. Unfortunately, I will stay again, and I never worry, the chartered financial analyst, oblique certified financial analyst, or Faltu Risk Management, FRM, CFA, FRM, GARP, and all these courses, they are charging thousands of dollars, but at the end of the day, most majority of their syllabus are either obsolete or they are useless. to be honest. And I really never mind challenging them. I really never mind challenging them. But what happened that most of the people just put a hand on your heart. You might be knowing a lot of people in the CFA. They end up nowhere. Few end up as an analyst. Slowly over the period of their career, they end up as a manager. But more than that, nothing. We will give you the realistic picture about the how the actually market works. As you know that we are more than 790 videos, and I hope that one feedback which I require from your side, if you exclude our videos from YouTube, you hardly have any YouTube channel who gives you the realistic picture about the treasury market, because everyone talks about rosy things and no one talk about the high-end derivatives. And I always shoot video for the class. I never shoot video for the mass. Last but not the least, I will assure you the kind of value addition we did in the YouTube, the kind of value addition we're doing on the LinkedIn, our 44 WhatsApp groups which we are running, wherein we are serving not less than 10,000 people per day. I will assure you that the value addition would be double or maybe triple when we're going to shoot the movie. Every line which we're going to talk about the movie would have a value and would be well researched. It takes 6 to 7 months to shoot the complete movie and at 4 different locations, and then finally the summarization of the movie, and then some editing work has to be done, and then finally it will come on the Amazon. To cut the long discussion short, I'm never worried about 3 things while shooting the movie. Number 1. What an Indian banks would be thinking, because I will not cover eye of Indian banks in the movie. They don't deserve to be in our movie. Number 1. Secondly, none of the Indian corporates, except 1 or 2, you guessed what I'm talking, except 1 or 2 would come in the movie. None of the Indian corporates. Majority of the data which we are taking in the movie, we will take from Google, or we will do our research also. We will give you source as well. Last but not the least, one thing I would like to assure you that this movie would really be an eye-opener for most of the people. That this movie will tell you that maybe the big Hollywood movies like Margin Call, The Big Shorts and all, they opened just 1-2% eyes of the people, but this movie would open a lot of eyes of the people. And with this, I am very thankful to somebody in the sky, my Lord. I started the company 3 years before, and now within 3 years the company has not done a respectable job, not only done a respectable job, but also I have never thought that the project Julia, the project Smith, followed by project Christine, and now our movie will come. I am too much hopeful that by 2022 we will not only be able to conclude our front office architecture, but also able to conclude middle office architecture, and hopefully by 2024 we will go for the license of a bank. And I assure you one thing, that when Treasury Consulting would be a bank, then it would be the big scene in the banking sector, because today bank always have an upper hand on the clients, but in our case clients would have an upper hand on the bank, and it the clients would be well serviced, that my assurance, because I am not Paytm, I am not Flipkart, I am not Snapdeal, I am not Mahindra, I am not Jabong, I am not Oyo, who not only changes the goal and the goal post. My goal is same, bang, and my goal post is also same, bang. I am living to secure one dream, that how can I be bang, and what are the steps I need to take to be a bang. With this, Treasury Consulting, thank you very much. All those people, those who do not like us, they can press the down button of the YouTube, because you give us a lot of encouragement once you press the down button. And all the people, those who do not like us, I would like to assure you one thing, that the more the down buttons you press, more encouragement I would get. And I assure you that 1,000 video YouTube channel is not far. We are few videos away from 800, and once we would be 1,000 videos, we will, our direction would be 2,000 video, and once we would be 1,000, which we are expecting by 15th to 30th December, anytime in between, we would be the second YouTube channel after Khan who would have 1,000 videos, because today Khan Academy hold more than 1,000 videos, 4-digit videos, and we currently are 3-digit videos. With this, Treasury Consulting would like to thank you very much. You know my mobile number, +91, which is an Indian code, 9899242978. You know our fixed income platform, www.fixedincome.global. By the way, you must have noticed why I'm looking at this screen. Because of a very good news that there is a whistleblower who came in the public domain and said that GE is a fraud bigger than Enron. I don't know, he is right. I don't know, he is wrong. But one thing I know, if he is coming in the public domain and challenging the GE, and until he holds all the facts, because whatever limited information which is coming in the media does suggest that 170 pager report he submitted to the Wall Street Journal. I don't know whether this report is in the public domain or not. I'll sure look at tomorrow because it's already 6 in the morning. But that's going to be very interesting, that a whistleblower coming in the public domain and challenging a company like GE, saying that GE is a bigger fraud than Enron. And with due respect to GE and that whistleblower, I don't know. The court of law of the US will decide. I don't know. But if that would happen, I will surely cover this in our movie. Have a good time, and I'll assure you, life in Treasury market is going to get shoot. The first part of the movie, shooting start 5 to 7 days from now. Have a good time. Talk soon.